Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. In today's video, I'm going to be creating this makeup look right here. It's a traditional ethnic sari makeup look and I'm really in love with this look. Oh my god guys, look at the glow. I love this look and this is one of my favorite looks so far. And I've used some good quality branded yet low cost products in this video. And I paired my sari with a German silver neck piece and earrings and it looked really good. If you're a person who loves ethnic traditional makeup, then you should definitely try this out because it's just an amazing makeup. And yeah, if you want to know how I have created this makeup look, then you know what to do. Keep on watching.
நீங்களும் ஜாலியா வீட்ல இருந்தே சம்பாதிக்கணுமா?
டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்ல இருக்க லிங்க்ல போய் மீஷோ ரீசெல்லிங் ஆப் டவுன்லோட் பண்ணுங்க.
ஒரு ரூபா கூட முதலீடு தேவையில்லை.
இந்த ஆப் எப்படி யூஸ் பண்ணி சம்பாதிக்கணும் தெரியணும்னா மேல இருக்க கார்ட்ஸ் கிளிக் பண்ணி டீடைல்டான வீடியோ போய் பாருங்க. Initially, I used LA Girl Eyeshadow Quad and took this dark brown shade and used it for my eyebrows. I outlined it initially and then filled it. I always love to do my eyebrows first before doing my face makeup because there will be some fallouts and something of that sort. So I want to do my eye makeup always in the beginning. Then I used LA Girl HD Pro Conceal. The shade details and the links, everything will be mentioned in the description box down below. I used it to correct my eyebrows because I haven't trimmed my eyebrows for such a long time and I want my makeup to be perfect. So I'm doing in this way so that it will look really good. Then I'm using Color Bar Perfect Match Compact Powder and I'm just setting my eyelid so that it won't crease for my eyeshadow. Then I used Dermdoc Anti-Acne Cream. It's a very good moisturizer. It has hyaluronic acid and salicylic acid and I'm applying this all over my face and I'm massaging it. I want to moisturize my skin before my eye makeup because I felt that my skin was too dry. Then I'm using Makeup Revolution eyeshadow palette and using this light shade and applying that all over my lid, concentrating more on my crease. I always love to use this shade as my transition color. I will leave the link of this also in the description box down below. There are a lot of offers going on right now in Makeup Revolution, LA Girl and a lot of good drugstore brands. If you want, you can check it out and you can just go to the link and see the offers, price and everything. Then I'm going to use the same palette and taking this dark brown shade and applying that on my crease. I just want my eye to look good and I always love to apply darker shades on my crease and this is what I'm doing for this look today. I'm showing only like 10 to 20 seconds of blending but I literally blended for like more than 10 minutes so that the look will be flawless and there will be no harsh lines. Then I'm taking the same light shade from the palette and applying that all over my lid and I'm kind of blending it. Now I'm taking this dark brown shade from this LA Girl eyeshadow quad and applying that on my outer corner. I always love to use darker colors on my outer corner so that it will look good basically and that is what I'm doing in this look as well. Now I'm taking Makeup Revolution Pro Illuminate Highlighter and applying that on my inner corner. Then again I'm taking the light brown shade from the Makeup Revolution palette and applying that on my eyelid and blending the dark brown and everything in. And using a wipes, I'm just going to crisp cut the eyeshadow. Now using the LA Girl Glide On Gel Liner and applying that on my upper waterline, if that's what it's called as. I'm going to use a Spaces Magnetized Liner and applying a wing liner. Because we are not using a lot of glitter and all in this makeup look, I just wanted a very good thick wing liner. Now I'm going to use this Sugar Pore Minimizing Primer and applying that in the places where I have pores and in my T-zone. Then I'm using L'Oreal Accord Perfect Foundation and Faces Glam On Foundation. Faces is way too lighter than me and L'Oreal is way too darker than me. I always love to mix foundations. If you cannot find your perfect shade, then you can buy darker foundation and lighter foundation and you can mix them both and apply it. This will be the best way to get your perfect shade because sometimes we get tan, sometimes we look fair, so that If we mix foundations, we can use our perfect shade all the time, and that is what I do. So I'm just using a makeup sponge to blend it. I always love using makeup sponge because it will make our skin to glow, and also it will be blended really nicely and our skin will look smooth as well. Now I'm going to use two concealers for my under eye. Initially I'm using LA Girl HD Pro Conceal. The links, the shade and everything will be mentioned in the description box down below. This is like almost my shade and I'm applying that to conceal my dark circles, and then using a lighter shade which is Wet n Wild Concealer and applying that to highlight my under eye, and I'm blending that with the same sponge. Then I'm using the same L'Oreal Accord Perfect Foundation that was way too darker than me, so I'm using it to contour. So I'm applying that underneath my cheekbone and blending that with a foundation blending sponge. And I'm going to contour my jawbone as well as my nose. Here I stand, I know I walked away. Had to find the person I'd become. You should go back home, go back home. It's time to highlight that nose and my chin. So I'm using the same Wet n Wild concealer in the shade, I don't know, you have to check the description box for that. And I'm blending that with the same sponge but in the different side. Then again using the same Color Bar Perfect Match Compact Powder, and I'm setting my under eye and my T-zone. I don't want to set my face because my face is already dry and I want to look dewy, so I'm not setting my entire face. And then I'm going to use the same Makeup Revolution eyeshadow palette, and I'm using this shade right here, and I'm going to contour like bronze my skin. I love bronzing, and I'm using a very kabuki kind of a brush from Focalure, and I'm blending that. It's time for blushing. So for that I'm using LA Girl Just Blushing Blush and applying that on my cheekbone. I'm not going overboard, I just want really minimal blush on my face. So yeah, then I'm using the same Makeup Revolution Pro Illuminate Highlighter and highlighting my face. Highlighting is the favorite part and I'm really not gonna skip it, and I'm applying loads of highlighter on the highest points of my face. You should go back home. Now I'm using Faces Canada Ultime Pro Primer Plus Matte Lip Crayon. I guess that is the name. And I'm using that for my lips. It's a bold lip color. I love this lipstick and I love this shade as well. Just go to the description box and find the link. It is such an amazing lipstick. And now I'm going to use a dark brown shade from the Makeup Revolution palette and applying that right below my waterline so that it will look smudged. And the look will be really good only if we apply eyeshadow underneath our eye, like underneath our waterline. That is what I meant. So yeah, I'm going to use the LA Girl Glide On Gel Liner and applying that on my lower waterline. I'm not going really bold, I just want a subtle kajal. Then I'm using the Lakme Iconic Curling Mascara and applying that on my lashes. I'm giving like more than 20 to 30 coats because I'm not using false lashes for today and I want my lashes to look thick and long. And because it's a sari, I don't think it will look good without bindi. So I'm just using a red maroonish bindi and I'm finishing the look. And I hope you really love this look. Make sure you subscribe below.